Good morning, everybody. Hope you've had a good week of selling. Well, we've got some new hires. And as one of the few employers of any renown left, we take great pride in taking on new salesmen. Because food is so scarce, and the harsh environment makes its transportation possible only in our own proprietary food containers, we truly are the lifeblood of the United States. Remember, United Comestibles is not in the food business serving people. We're in the people business serving food. I'd like to recognize Rich Grisham for surpassing his sales quota this week. Congratulations, Rich. Alright, people, let's get out there and sell some food. Now remember, Manny's team starts on Quadrant 4 this week, so keep that in mind.
Mayonnaise sandwiches.
That's all I got. Can't afford that imitation hamburger.
It is a bit of a luxury.
I saw the astronaut again last night.
I know. I can tell. Why else did you invite me here?
He left me this sort of joystick or remote or something.
The remote? Really?
What do you mean, the remote?
I've heard stories. This is Artemis to a T. But why would your grandfather give the remote to you?
I have no idea. What does it even do?
Project Artemis was the military counterpart to the Apollo program. Try and stay one step ahead of the communists. Sorry to tell you this, kid, but your grandfather installed nuclear ballistics on the moon. A last resort type of thing, you see.
You mean to tell me that there are nuclear warheads on the moon pointed at the former Soviet Union?
Not at the Soviet Union, at America. When I said last resort, I meant last resort. In case of a Soviet invasion, the President, the Secretary of Defense, whoever the hell, could launch it from their secret asshole bunker. Last resort, last chance, whatever you want to call it.
And this remote launches that attack.
Okay.
What the hell are you doing?
Say hello to Marilyn.
Nuclear powered space shuttle exploded high in the atmosphere, killing myself and nearly rendering the entire planet uninhabitable. I kept that remote high up in outer space where no one could touch it. I got lonely though, and I thought I could finally entrust it to you.
You could have told me what it does at least.
I know. I've just never been very good at expressing. I thought that staying distant would be the best way. Plus, I never met you and I was pretty nervous. I died before you were born, you know.
I'm well aware of that.
But I've made a terrible mistake. McMillan worked on that project with me, and now he wants to blow up America. That guy's nuts. You've got to go stop him.
Well, where is he?
He's at the Deer Lake Drive-In. That was a front for the missile command post. McMillan knows that he can launch the missiles from there. You better hurry. May the speed of science forever guide your path.
Exposed to radiation hundreds of times. Government secret, you know?
Yeah.